Ice up. Ice up. Indies. Indies. Yeah. Live free, speak your peace. Stay humble in these streets, yeah. In these streets. Let's go. Playground parks with the trees and the cars. Brownstone buildings with the kids on the porch. Murals on the walls for the ones that we lost. Bodegas on the corner, let me see what's in store. Subway stations with the maps in the cars. Summer cookouts, uncle got the sandals on. Statue of Liberty.
We're going back to school.
School's in when it comes to Burger Town.
We're actually in Kitsilano. Kitsilano is a beautiful part of Vancouver.
Right? It's Jimbob and Danny, and we're here for another episode of Burger Week.
Number three.
Where are we going to today, Dan?
VERA'S. VERA'S is an interesting burger place. Started in 1977 as a concession by the beach, just down over there by the water. And Vera and her husband ran it. Then they turned it over some years later to their granddaughters. And in 2001, I believe, Trent, I believe is his name. Gerald. Gerald's his first name. Took it over with his partner, and they've been carrying on the tradition. We've heard great things about this burger. I've never tried a Vera's, so this is going to be a brand new experience together as we look for the best burger in BC.
I know.
As we're about to head in, Dan, what's your anticipation score? What do you think is coming? What do you expect?
I mean, based on everything I've heard and the history, it's in all the magazines. People talk about Vera's. My expectation score would be right at about 4 or 5.5.
Okay, I'm gonna come in a little shy of that. I'm gonna say 4.3. Let's have a burger.
You ready for this?
I'm ready. Are you ready?
It's gonna be good.
Let's go.
Come on, let's go inside.
I handled this so well. I know we had the right intentions, but somehow it came to an end. I was looking for a remedy. Special. I thought I handled this so well. I know we had the right intentions, but somehow it came to an end. I was looking for a remedy. Now I better who's in front of me. I was looking for a remedy.
Now I better who's in front of me. What do you got on your burger there?
Now this is a lamb burger, which I'm very excited about. I love lamb. Got some jalapeno poppers on here that are gonna give it a nice little spice.
Smells like a picnic barbecue with a kind of a fresh bun, homemade kind of bun smell to it. And wow, there's lots on that top. Got some perky tomato, with some bacon, a little mozzarella cheese. And this is the Vera burger.
This is the Vera.
This is the Vera.
This is the Vera.
Let's
go for the taste. Let's see what this burger looks like.
First impressions?
It's a lamb burger. It's got a nice lamb flavor, which is a very unique. Good, very good. I'm getting back to bison type excitement here with this lamb burger.
Yep.
Nice. Very nice. fries too. Very nice fries. Hot fries, homemade.
This is an exciting hamburger.
Yeah?
I'm serious. This is good.
How does that compare to the bison?
Right up there.
Really?
Right up there. It's going to be really, really hard not to give it the same taste for. For taste, I'm going to go with 4.95. 4.95.
So that's right in there with the bison burger. Yeah.
Almost the bison. It is in the wow zone.
It's gonna be a mix back and forth depending on the category, but the meat and the taste overall, it's gonna come in just under the fat burger. I'm gonna give this for taste 4.2.
4.2, okay. 4.2 on the VERA'S burger.
Nothing really wrong with it, but other burgers have been more right.
And so forth, but the food itself came out in plates. Everything was in its spot. There was nothing running over the side. The burger was well put together. All the condiments were inside. Fries were great. So I think I'm going with a 4.4. How about you? Jimbob burrito.
I think this is accessible. I think this is beach food, easy walk-in anytime. What place is clean, quick service, friendly staff, good staff. You can see the grill, it's clean, they're doing good work there. Everything is very competent and well done. Just not the combination for me to go for that. Best of the best, but solid great work. Oh, sorry, 4.05. Yep, that's where I'm at.
Okay.
Iso.
What'd you think?
I loved the lamb burger. I was very excited about the taste.
You've had some treats. You've really...
I have had some treats.
You've really found your passion with the bison. I wasn't sure if you were going to get another hit like that, and this one came close.
Yeah, VERA'S burger is a good tasting, well put together lamb burger. Now, I think there was a little bit of concern on your part with the VERA'S burger, their signature. Wasn't exactly what you thought it might be, or
no? I wouldn't say it was concern. I just think, you know, it's all of the burgers are great,
right?
But we're looking for the best of the best,
right?
And for me, with the other burgers that I've had Monday, Tuesday, this one just came in third. So I just got to give it the honest score. It's not a bad burger. 4.0 and up is exceptional. It's a great burger, but I think the fat burger was better yesterday, and no question the Hulk burger, you know, is in a different level. It's a different caliber, in my books.
Yeah, I think what you found as the burger, the way it was put together with the other condiments, the other parts of the hamburger, played nicer at fat burger, and here perhaps the meat was very good, by itself, but the rest...
No, the other way around, actually.
The other way around.
Some of the accompaniments here were exceptional. The proportion of each individual item was very good here and tasty. The meat, I thought, was, I don't want to say lackluster, but it was just one step down from what we had the last couple of days. Not bad, but not great.
Okay.
Just sliding in at a 4.0. So I'm not disappointed. It's pretty much where I thought it was going to be, but it's not going to beat the other burgers out in my scorebook.
Okay.
How about yourself? What do you give it for a score? Going back to the beginning, the anticipation, the promise of what was coming,
right,
and now the delivery. How was the delivery for you?
I think on the delivery, the overall, I would go with about a 4.45.
4.45.
So, you know, room to join the ranks of what we've experienced so far.
That's elite.
That's up there. It's generously above the 4-point average it's getting on Google.
You know, if you've got a favorite spot, or if you disagree with us, you think something is better or worse, comment. Everyone's opinion matters, and we like to hear your feedback, positive, negative, whatever
you
think.
Thank you for watching. We really appreciate it. Looking forward to being with you in person as soon as we can.
Thanks for those of you who referred us to VERA'S. Great option.
Yep.
If you're in the neighborhood, check it out.
Right over here.
Bye-bye.
VERA'S. based on experience where, again, we're not hired for these burger films. We're doing this on our own.
We're not sponsored by VERA'S. They didn't know we're coming.
Not sponsored at all.
It's unannounced. It's unscheduled. We don't call ahead. We just show up, grab burgers, and then see how they go.
Putting them together, hoping they're entertaining and bringing value to guys that come to enjoy BackYawd and the different emphases in the future. Right now, we're focused on 7 burgers in 7 days, looking for the best in BC. Where are we going next for number 4?
Stay tuned. You gotta come back to find out. I won't tell.
And what should they do with the buttons on there under the video?
You know, just click that like.
The like.
The subscribe.
Subscribe.
And ring my bell.
Ring my bell. Should they watch the whole video?
Watch the whole video a few times. You know, study it. Fall asleep with it running.
Right.
And comment.
They should watch the commercials.
Like and comment.
Playground parks with the trees and the cars. Brownstone buildings with the kids on the porch. Murals on the walls for the ones that we lost. Bodegas on the corner, let me see what's in store. Subway stations with the maps and the cars. Summer cookouts, uncle got the sandals on. Statue of Liberty.